皆様こんにちは。ニューバーガーバーマンの藤波と申します。本日はアジア 5G の動画をご覧になっていただき誠にありがとうございます。今回はアジア 5G のポートフォリオマネージャーであります香港の YT ブーンを招いて、皆様にアジア 5G についてより深くご理解いただけるよう4つの質問をしてみたいと思います。 YT、 早速ですが、2月の運用開始来のパフォーマンスの推移について、そしてコロナ禍における投資行動について解説いただけますか？
Thank you for having me on this video shooting. So the first question on performance. We launched this fund in February and had some COVID related challenges right after. During the downturn, our fund performed mostly in line with the broader market. However, we quickly made some changes.To the portfolio. And thanks to these investment actions, our fund outperformed very well during the snapback period. The key investments to highlight are that we added to Meituan in April. This is an internet company which enables online food delivery and travel booking services in China. And this stock has outperformed by about 175% since we added.We also initiated on M3, a key enabler in Japan for telemedicine, in May. Though this name is one of the high performers within the Japan stock market, we were able to invest early and the stock performed nearly 150% since the inception. Additionally, due to our view that there would be more demand for data centers,On the back of increasing trend of work from home and online video streaming, we added to China data center provider GDS Holdings. We think these companies have lots of room for earnings growth and expect to lead our performance in the future.
ありがとうございます。今最後に高成長ということについて言及されました。一方、ポートフォリオのバリエーションの水準についてはいかがでしょうか？ポートフォリオの11月末の予想 PR は約70倍など、市場の平均値よりは高い水準と言えますが。
Since our portfolio is tilted to growthy names, it is natural to say that valuation is higher than normal. And I think it is a matter of balance between the growth opportunity and market expectations. Our holdings in average is expected to growits EPS by about 35% on an annual basis for the coming 3 years. This is consensus-based estimates, and we think the reality should be much higher once the importance of the emerging technologies starting to get realized. So do we think that portfolio valuation is high? I would say it is in a comfortable zone, but we're disciplined on valuations.We track every single holding's current value with our target price. Even if a company has strong or huge growth opportunity, we would also sell or take profit if we think valuations are not justified by its growth.
ありがとうございます。次の質問はもう少しマクロ的なものになります。今後のアジアにおける 5G の普及について見通しをお聞かせください。
So as you may know, we already saw 5G proliferating in China, South Korea, and Japan during 2020. This pace should accelerate into 2021 due to more infrastructure being rolled out and more 5G smartphones being launched. Separately, we should see more new launches for the laggard countries like India, Singapore, Malaysia, Indonesia, and so forth.We are thrilled because we might be able to capture new investment opportunities when we see more of these proliferations in the 5G lagged countries.
見通しをお話しいただきましてありがとうございます。最後になりますが、アジア 5G ではアジア以外、例えば欧米の銘柄を組み入れていますよね。こうした非アジア株を保有する意図は何でしょうか？
Good question.So we focus on growth 5G related opportunities in Asia. This would include non-Asian companies which has certain revenue exposures and growth opportunities within Asia. One example is a Swiss semiconductor company, STMicroelectronics, which is a non-Asian holding. This company is exposed to compound semiconductor and is providing emerging technologies for 5G related devices. The other example is ASM International, which is a company based in the Netherlands. This company provides deposition equipment, which is necessary for next generation semiconductor manufacturing. Though these companies are European based, more than half of their revenues are coming from Asia. So companies like STMicroelectronics and ASM International, which has both, you know, material exposures to emerging technologies and also in Asia, which could be included in the portfolio.
YT、貴重なお話をありがとうございます。またお会いできることを楽しみにしています。
Thank you. ありがとうございます。